This is a Friday Shoes production. This is lesson 4-7 in our books on page 218. Our target is I can identify similar polygons and find missing measures of similar figures. We will be using proportions from previous lessons. Similar polygons. What are polygons? A polygon consists of a sequence of consecutive line segments in a plane placed end to end to form a simple closed figure. You can see they used quadrilaterals here. You could have triangles, pentagons, and so forth. Polygons that have the same shape are called similar polygons. So if they have the same shape, they are called similar polygons. In the figure below, polygon ABCD is similar to polygon WXYZ. This is written as polygon ABCD, and then they have that little squiggly, which means similar to polygon WXYZ. Let's talk about similar. The parts of similar figures that match are called corresponding parts. Corresponding parts are your angles and your sides. You can see that they have angle A here and angle W colored in pink there, and those are corresponding angles. Likewise with the others, and you can read that there in the chart. Same with sides. Side AB, it corresponds with side WX. They've kind of colorized all of those. You can see them in the chart here. Those are all corresponding sides. They match up the sides. There's a symbol that we need to know. It's called the congruent symbol. And that symbol is circled right there. And that means is congruent to. That's how you read it. We also use arcs. Arcs are used to show congruent angles, meaning the same degrees. I use those over here. You can kind of see me highlighting them again. Those are called arcs. All right, similar polygons, the key concept here. If two polygons are similar, what makes them similar? There's two things you need. Their corresponding angles are congruent, or the same degree measure, or have the same measure, they say. And the second thing, so here's the first thing. Second thing would be the measures of their corresponding sides are proportional. Proportional meaning the ratios are all equal. That means, for instance, AB and XY, that ratio is the same as BC and YZ, which is the same as AC and XZ. And to prove those or show you this in the real world here, let's do an example. It says identify similar polygons. Are these polygons similar, these two rectangles here? Determine whether these rectangles HJKL is similar to rectangle MNPQ and explain. You look at them and you go, man, they look similar. Well, are they similar? Yeah, they're both rectangles, but are they similar? First, we see that the angles are all the same. Well, that's what we check first. You can see that right there. They're all right angles. That's great. Since the two polygons are rectangles, all their angles are right angles. Therefore, all corresponding angles are congruent. You can't stop there. Look at the student tip. Common error is you can't assume the two polygons are similar just because their corresponding angles are congruent. Their corresponding sides must also be proportional. So again, we've checked off one of the boxes, but we need to find out if the corresponding sides are going to be proportional. So let's write those ratios down. So you see they have HJ, the long side, corresponds with MN. So they've created 7 over 10 right here. And that's your 7 tenths. Same thing, they take the JK, and that corresponds with NP here, and they've put that there. Now, they've done all four of them. I'm not going to do all four of them, but you can see 7 tenths and 1 half, those aren't the same ratios. So, therefore, we can stop right there, and I can say since 7 tenths and 1 half are not equivalent ratios, rectangle HJKL is not similar to rectangle MNPQ. Again, in the beginning, you look at it, you go, ah, they look similar. Well, they are rectangles, but they're not similar rectangles because it's not proportional. All right, you give it a shot on these. Stop the video, try B, and then try A. I've switched them just because we just did a rectangle. Maybe it'd be easier for you. And then come on back, see how you do. It says, determine whether these polygons are similar, then explain. Well, first off, let's take a look at these sides. We have KL, MJ, and ABCD. Well, if I'm looking at the KL part, that's the small part on the small rectangle, that would relate to, correspond to AB on the big one. So I have 1.5 over 6. All right, well, let's look at the bigger side. Again, KLMJ is going to be on top, ABCD is going to be on bottom. So look at the JK, that's 3.5, and then we've got the DA, which will be 14 on the bottom. Are those the same? That's really what you're asking. So let's take a look at what I've done here. 1.5 over 6 and 3.5 over 14, are those the same? Well, just cross multiply. When you do, you actually get the same value. So, and the value of that would be 21. Yes, they are similar. And you'll notice up at the top there, I said KLMJ in the circle is similar to ABCD with squiggly. Let's take a look at A here. Well, you got isosceles triangles here. We've got the first part, which is our 6 over 8, and then our 6 over 8, and then our 8 over 12. So I'm just corresponding those sides and making those ratios. And we're asking, you see the question marks, are those all the same? Well, obviously 6/8 and 6/8 is the same, but guess what? 8/12 doesn't equal the same as 6/8. It's not 3/4, it's actually 2/3. So our answer is these are not similar figures. These are not similar triangles. All right, the ratio of the lengths of two corresponding sides of two similar polygons is called the scale factor. You can use the scale factor of similar figures or a proportion to find missing measures. Take a look at our first example here. We're going to find this missing length called M here in this example. It says, given that polygon WXYZ is similar to polygon ABCD, find the missing measures. You can see they've already put the arcs in there to show you everything here. These two figures are similar just by the given statement there. So we can then use the information, the lengths of these sides, to find that missing piece. Let's take a look at the first example. First method, excuse me. It says, first thing we do, the missing measure, M, is the length XY. So we'll write a proportion using that. So we have XY corresponds with BC. You can see that's what they've done there. And then they go and find YZ and CD. These both have numbers in them. So we have YZ and CD. Both those have numbers. And notice the tops of these are both from WXYZ, and the bottoms are both from ABCD. Erase all that, gets a little messy. So once we put these together, you put the numbers in, here's the missing piece, here's the 12, here's the 15, here's the 10. So we're going to cross multiply, and that's what we get next here. 12 times 15 is 180. Let's divide by this 10 on both sides, and the answer will be 18. So M is 18. It's a good method too. It's using the scale factor. It says first, find the scale factor from the polygon WXYZ to polygon ABCD. So we start with this on top and this on bottom. So we'll take our YZ, which we know is 15 from the picture, and we'll take our 10, which we know from the picture, and then we'll just reduce it down to 3 over 2, or 1.5. That's called the scale factor. It's also called the constant of proportionality, which we talked about in previous lessons. All right, so the words are this. It says a length on the polygon WXYZ is 3/2 times as long as a corresponding length on polygon ABCD. 3 over 2 is 1.5. So it's 1.5 times as long. So what do we do? Well, let the M represent the measure of XY, which we're looking for. And we take M, and we say that's equal to 1.5, or 3 over 2, times the 12, which we do have. So 12 times 3.5, as you can see, is 18. That's using scale factor. How about you give it a shot here with WZ and AB? All right, with WZ, here's what we do first. We know that WZ relates to AD. You can see that. WZ relates to AD. We're going to use ZY and DC, because those have the numbers there. So notice I plugged those in pieces of information that I have D in there for WZ. So D over 13 is equal to 15 over 10. simply cross multiply and solve. When we cross multiply, 13 times 15 is 195. We divide by 10, we get 19.5. So D is 19.5, which is actually the WZ. All right, the second one, let's use the scale factor. The scale factor, again, if we use our ZY and our DC, we see that it's 15 to 10. So our 15 to 10, which is actually reduced to 3 over 2, is our scale factor. So WX over AB, and we're looking for AB, we have to match it up with our WX. We set it equal to our scale factor. Kind of doing a little bit different the way the book shows it here. Well, then we put in what we have. We have WX, which is 24. A is the length of AB. And then we just use our scale factor, 3 over 2. And from there, cross multiply and solve. We get 48 is equal to 3A. Divide by 3, A is 16. All right. Perimeters are also proportional. What it says here is look at square A and square B. They're similar. Square A is similar to square B with a scale factor of 3 to 2. Notice that the ratio of their perimeters is 12 to 8 or 3 to 2. What they're saying is take a look at these squares. Well, if one side is 3, the other sides are 3 as well. When you add all those up, you equal 12 meters. Same with this square here that has 2. When you add all those up, that equals 8. Well, if you just took one side to the other side, that'd be 3 to 2. Well, guess what? If you add all these up, that's 12 and that's 8. 12 to 8. Those are equal. That means they're proportional. Remember, 2 times 12 and 3 times 8 is 24, so those are proportional. Where can we use this? It says this and other related examples suggest the following, and here it is. Key concept to get. Ratios of similar figures. If two figures are similar with a scale factor of A over B, whatever those numbers may be, then the perimeters of the figures have a ratio of that same value, A over B. That's what we just proved up there. All right, take a look at this example. It says triangle LMN, excuse me, I get as high as I can here. LMN is similar to triangle PQR. Is the perimeter of triangle LMN, if the perimeter of triangle LMN is 64 units, what is the perimeter of triangle PQR? Well, let's read this at him. You know the measures of two corresponding sides and the perimeter of triangle LMN. You need to find the perimeter of PQR, that triangle. Well, triangle LMN is similar to triangle PQR with a scale factor of 24 to 18. This one came first, this one came second, so we write 24 over 18. And we reduce that down, we divide by 6, and you'll see that's why we have our 4 over 3. The ratio of the perimeter of triangle LMN to triangle PQR is also 4 over 3, which we proved in that previous example. It's going to be the same. So, what do? We set it equal. Putting 64 on top, what we're looking for on bottom, calling it X, and then we write our scale factor over on the left, 4 over 3. Of course, we cross multiply, and then we solve, dividing by 4 on the last step, and that's equal to 48. So, if we look at the answers up here, obviously, that's going to be C. How about you give it a shot right here? Stop the video. Try this one. Come on back. See how you did. Square KLMN is similar to square TUVW. If the perimeter of square KLMN is 32 units, what is the perimeter of square TUVW? Well, we're starting with this statement. That's the first sentence. KLMN is similar to TUVW. So let's look at the scale factor. We're going from KLMN to TUVW, so I'm going to put 8 over the 16. Whichever comes first, I put that one first. 8 over the 16. All right? Then what I do is I say, okay, we'll take our KLMN, which is 32 units for our perimeter, and put that over the perimeter of, perimeter will equal the perimeter for this particular, or P will equal the perimeter for that particular square, in this case, UVWT. So, what do we do now? First, we cross multiply and then solve. That actually works out nice. P is actually 64. So our final answer, H is 64. Don't forget, you can rewatch this video or read the examples in the book, which I just did. You can also watch some of the personal video or tutor videos that are online in our online textbook. And as usual, this has been a Friday Shoes production.